What is the sound of Philadelphia? Oh my God, I can get into a million different things, and it wasn't one or two people that really started it. It was basically the singers, the rhythm section, Sigma Sound, the engineers, the way they placed the microphones, the way they would record the sound of the drums.
When we get a chart, I would have an idea of what I think the drums should sound like in this song. Norman Harris would have an idea of what he thinks he should play. Ronnie Baker, the bass player, would have an idea of what he thinks to play. Gamp would have an idea. Huck would have an idea. So what we would do, even before the session, we would just jam. That gets everybody loose to feeling. So if they hear something, Gamble and Huff would have the last word. They would say, well, look, this I like or this I don't like. And we would record it. But we would come in the studio and create different grooves, like for the love of money. The only time that we really had, I would say that we had a tough time, was my toughest time in the studio was when I came in with Tommy Bell. And when I came in with Tommy Bell was when I really had to learn how to read music, because nothing is played by ear.
What is the Philly sound? I'm asked that everywhere I go, what is the Philly sound? The Philly sound came from a group of people that were together. It was us writing the songs, then we went in the studio with the musicians who played all of the music. And then it came to the studio, who had a certain sound, just like when you hear about Motown, that I heard you ask somebody earlier about the movie they had on Motown. They didn't talk, they talked about the musicians, but they didn't talk about the equipment that they used. There was certain equipment they used to get a certain sound, and that's where Sigma Sound came in. When they sat down to do a session, they had a sound on Ronnie Baker on the bass, had a sound on Norman Harris on the guitar, Roland Chambers on his guitar, Lenny McCool on whatever he played, Earl Young. They had the sound, so they didn't have to say, well, how do we get this guy's sound? They do so many sessions.
See, every song that I've heard to come out of Philadelphia had an aura around it that had beautiful orchestration and beautiful string lines and bells and those type of things, and beautiful lyric structure, and beautiful hooks. You know what I mean? Like, never gonna give you up no matter how. What a beautiful song. What a beautiful song. I would describe the sound of Philadelphia as absolute class.
How these sounds evolved is directly related to their elaborate bass lines and catchy rhythms. Melodies that communicated basic feelings. Music that cut through all cultural and language barriers. Silk voices singing in high register. Lush string instruments. Funky beats. All were closely associated with this sound from Philadelphia.
When we first started out, they had the group called the Romeos. They were one of the best groups, instrumentally groups in Philadelphia. So you had them backing you up. So they backed us up. They were like our band, the Kenny Gamble, the Huff, Tommy Bell, Roland Chambers, Carl Chambers, you know. And I remember when Tommy Bell said, well, hey, man, I'm going to go to school to start learning arrangements. And I said, yeah, okay. Next thing I know, phew, it's gone. Next thing I know, Gamble and Huff comes into existence.
There's a group called Herb Johnson and the Impacts. Herb Johnson and the Impacts were a bar band around Philadelphia, and I got to be the guitar player. And we used to play at a place called the Vegas Bar at 52nd and Walnut. And one day, one fateful day, in walked this guy, and he says, oh man, could I get up on stage and do you know anything but Marvin Gaye or Jerry Butler? I said, sure, what do you want to, you know, what do you want to sing? So he sang He Will Break Your Heart, and he sang Can I Get a Witness, and it was Kenny Gamble, because he lived right down the street from where that bar was. So anyway, we got to know each other. He was a lab tech at Miss Ricordi Hospital. And so later on down the line, we started doing his thing after the Romeos phased out. So that when he was getting his new rhythm section together, I guess I was elected to be part of that.
Well, Kenny taught me how to play the guitar. We have become real soul mate brothers in regards to the day and what time it is. And he has been like an inspiration to so many people here in Philadelphia. Because I remember he used to come and sit on my step with his guitar, start playing and showed me a few songs that I remember. And I wanted to write. And he showed me a certain charisma of music.
Working with a variety of producers and arrangers, a consistent lineup of single-minded session musicians settled into the now famous Philly groove. They added sweeping strings and seductive horns to deep rhythms. And the vocalists remained as soulful as any artist at Motown in Detroit or Stax in Memphis. Producers such as Kenny Gamble, Leon Huff, Tom Bell, and a host of other talented musicians created the instrumental textures that came to distinguish the music.
I've had the opportunity to work in the studio with some of the most talented producers and arrangers. You know, that to me was like my school, my college. I mean, just knowing and working with Kenny Gamble and Leon Huff was just like going to school.
So much could be said about Kenny. Kenny was obviously a great inspiration for so many people because of his writing and his talents, you know, are so diverse in the styles of music he has done, and also as a leader to help give people an idea of how to live their lives, especially the black community. Was very inspirational, having a man like him that could write great music and give you pride and this, develop music that instills pride. No more back
thinking, time for thinking ahead. Huff is the first time I can remember him when I let the good time roll. I remember this little guy back at the piano. I don't know if he had a piano or organ. We're doing Let the Good Time Roll. I thought this guy was beating the piano with a hammer, but it was his hand. He's broken a lot of pianos. The strings, you have to be playing piano for that thing. Dun, 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 dun. It's like somebody got a bat. Boom, boom, boom. The whole bass, if you listen to those records, you hear the bass lines, but you hear that piano right up underneath it. And one thing a lot of people don't know, that Huff sings a bad baritone note. The song of Joe Simon, said, I'm drowning, drowning in the sea of love. That's me, Kenny, and Huff on that. And Huff is singing Brad Tone on, if you don't know me by now, you will never, never know.
Leon Huff was the more quiet one out of the duo of writers and producers, but the musical drive, I mean, a man that could play piano like nobody else. I mean, he learned it from, I don't know some of the great influences he had, but he just knew how to sit at a keyboard and drive a rhythm and a melody right into your heart with Kenny's great lyrics and melodies as well. The two of them just made a wonderful symbiotic relationship. What they do, they smile in your face.